What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. Today is the final video of 2020. I'm going to be doing kind of a year in review, and well, what a year it has been for everybody. But we're just going to be focusing here on this channel today and about my life, since this is My Corvette Life. If you've been following this channel for a while, you know that the beginning of this year was pretty tough for me. I had several family members pass away. Not going to get into too much detail about that. If you're curious about that, if you're new to the channel, go back and watch those videos. I explained the whole situation there. But to say the first 6 months of 2020 with that and then all this virus stuff happening, it was pretty depressing, I'm not gonna lie. As 2020 has been for most everybody, it's been a challenge to say the least. But as far as the YouTube channel goes, you know, I finished out 2019 at the highest point that the channel had ever seen. I had great momentum, and then all of this kind of personal family stuff happened, and I was unable to post for weeks, months at a time. So really, it kind of just all fell apart, it kind of seemed like. But after I kind of got past all of that negative stuff and was able to focus more on the YouTube channel, I have actually successfully posted a video every other day for at least the past 3, maybe 4 months now. And I posted consistently for, I think, the past 6 months. So I've been posting a ton of content. So I hope you guys have been enjoying that. And speaking of new content, you can see the C4 behind me. That was another big accomplishment for the year. We'll get to that in just a little bit, though. Some of the other highlights. I spent the entire summer basically tearing apart the C5 and rebuilding that whole thing. If you guys haven't seen those videos, I basically rebuilt the entire suspension. I did ball joints, hub assemblies. I polished all the suspension parts, all new bushings in the A-arms, motor mounts. I also did a fast intake. LS2 throttle body, larger fuel injectors, and we did get the car tuned, but unfortunately that isn't quite the end of the story, and that car sadly isn't going to end 2020 on a high note. But not to worry, we're going to get to that here shortly. To kind of cap that off, I think the C5 has been getting a little jealous of the C4 here recently, because it seems like since I got the C4, things on the C5 have just been going horribly wrong. Let me explain a little bit. So some of you guys might know, just as I finished up the big project on the C5, took the car down to the dyno. Car is all tuned, it's totally drivable. But it was having some ignition breakup up at the high RPMs, like 5,500 and above. So he was able to tune it, but to really get the final dyno number, I got to fix a few things. I've got some new ignition packs. There's some wiring on the fuel injectors that I still need to correct. Right now I'm using some like adapters, because there's a newer style plug on these fuel injectors. So I need to hardwire the newer style plugs on that wiring still. So that's still yet to come. And then right before I bought the C5, I cracked the coolant tank. So I noticed some coolant leaking, and right there where that hose connects to that plastic nipple right there, those things are notorious for cracking in that location. If you just even put the slightest amount of pressure when leaning over the fender on that thing, you'll crack it. And that's pretty much exactly what I did. So I do have a new coolant tank.
sitting on the workbench over there ready to go, but that is another project coming up here shortly.
And then since I bought the C4, a couple of things have happened. Just maybe a week or so ago, I came out to start up the C5. Hadn't started in a while. So I got in the car, went to crank it over, and it took a little bit longer to start than it usually does. It did start, but it cranked a few more times than normal, and I wasn't real happy about that. So I went and checked all the plug wires, and one was a little loose. So I went and grabbed the plug wire. The car was off at this point, mind you. Pulled the plug wire off, and this little metal piece here that is usually inside the plug wire stayed on the spark plug, and the wire came off. So this plug wire is bad now. So I went ahead and ordered a whole new set of plug wires that are sitting over there. So those are going to go in here shortly. Hopefully that will fix the issue that I'm having. And then, again, after I bought the C4, probably just around the same time that this happened, my in-laws were in town, and their car was sitting where the C4 is currently. It was getting a ceramic coating. The guy came over to the house and did it all right here. So my wife, smartly, I should say, told me that, hey, you should probably push in your mirror to give us a little bit more room, which I've done plenty of times. If you go over to this side, I usually tuck in my mirror on this side, so I got a little bit more room over here on the workbench side. So I go over here to push the mirror in, and I just give it the slightest push, and I heard a crack. So needless to say, I got a floppy mirror now. So that is wonderful. So that is going to require me taking the whole door panel apart and getting in there and figuring out what broke. What broke on it? I have no idea, because these are not electric folding mirrors. They should just fold in just like that manually. So I'm not sure exactly what cracked in here. So needless to say, I think the C5 is getting a little jealous of me from giving too much attention to the C4 recently, and it's having some temper tantrums. So got some work to do on the C5 now. So obviously the big news for 2020 as far as this channel goes is my purchase of the C4 you see behind me here. I did mention in one of my previous videos that a week after I bought this car, my viewership on this channel was up 98%. So that is amazing. You guys obviously love the C4 content, and I'm actually really, really excited about this project. I've got some cool stuff coming up here. I've got a huge parts list that I'm about to hit the purchase button here on January 1st. So there's going to be a ton of parts deliveries coming to the My Corvette house here pretty shortly. But it's pretty exciting. There's not a whole lot of people making C4 content on the internet here recently. And there's really nobody who's made how-to videos, you know, the style that I make them, about the C4 Corvette. So there's a few people here and there that make like one or two videos, but nobody who has really dedicated the time to make pretty much, you know, write the book on the car like I did on the C5 for the past 3 years. So we're pretty much going to be doing that with this car. We are going to do as many maintenance projects on this car as we possibly can, and then who knows what's going to happen. I did say that originally my plan was to sell this car, and I know all of you guys have been saying that I got to keep the car. So as long as you guys still love the videos and you guys are still watching them and you're still liking all the content, I'll keep the car for as long as you guys still watch. So don't worry about that. And I'm not going to give out any details just yet, but I might have a pretty cool end game for this car. Just gonna have to wait and see. It's gonna be a while though, at least a year or more. We got plenty of stuff to do on this car, so stay tuned. I will say that thanks to you guys, we are ending 2020 here on this YouTube channel really, really strong. A lot of that has to do with the C4 content, like I said. I will share with you guys that December was my largest revenue month that I've ever had here on YouTube. In fact, I earned about 40% more revenue in the month of December than I have ever before any month since I started this YouTube channel. So that is awesome. And that's all thanks to you guys. And like I've said before, all of the revenue for this channel goes right back into projects to create more content for this channel. None of the money goes into my pocket to buy, you know, stuff for my life. It all goes back to buy car parts or stuff that it is involved with this YouTube channel. So really, it's kind of a win-win for me and for you guys. You guys are funding what you're watching. So it's really an interesting dynamic. To my knowledge, to the level that I'm doing it, I don't think anybody else on YouTube is really doing it. You know, obviously the big YouTubers that earn millions of dollars, you know, they buy all the cars and stuff from with their YouTube revenue, but they're really making a living doing that. I have a day job besides this YouTube channel, and this is my side hobby. And thankfully, thanks to you guys, my side hobby has kind of funded itself, and it's self-sustaining now. In fact, hopefully within a month or two, I will have earned enough money to pay for this car. I did pay cash for the car out of my wife and I's own bank account, but I think I might be able to actually purchase this car via YouTube revenue and, you know, pay my wife back. So hopefully you guys can help me out and keep watching the videos. Like I said, a lot of parts are coming and have need to be ordered. So keep watching the videos. You're helping me, and you're helping me make more content for you. So one final note before I end this video. As of this video going live on December 31st, we are about 50 subscribers away from hitting 16,000 subscribers. That honestly blows my mind. And some of you might think that that's not that big of a deal, but I have had zero influence from any outside larger YouTubers. All of my subscribers have come, I'll say, naturally via the algorithm, via you guys searching for me, and via me sharing and posting my videos on other social media platforms. All of you guys have found me that way. So far, I haven't had any like mainstream YouTubers give me a big shout out, and I get a wave of people that way, which a lot of YouTubers start out that way. Like, I'll just name an example. Let's say StreetSpeed717 shouts out JimBob717, and he gets 10,000 subscribers in 24 hours. That didn't really happen to me. It's taken me over 3 years to acquire all of you guys, and honestly, I like it better that way, because all of you guys are real subscribers, and you all watch me, and you all care about me. The other way is kind of artificial, I feel. Like, they get the big number and they might earn more revenue than me. But the interaction between those guys and their followers isn't as real as me and you. I read every single one of your guys' comments and answer every single one of your questions to the best of my ability. I also read every single one of your emails, regardless if I reply or not. Just know I am reading your emails. And if you guys answer me questions, obviously I do my best to answer you. But I feel our connection here on this YouTube channel is a real thing. It's not just like you guys are reaching out to some uber famous person and you probably aren't going to hear from them or even know that they read your message. I read all of your guys' messages, and I hope you guys know that. So I enjoy the connection as much as you guys do, and I hope that continues, even if this YouTube channel eventually gets a million subscribers. Who knows? One day, maybe. But I'm still, regardless of how big this thing gets, I'm going to do my best to help you guys out. That's what this thing's all about. That's why I make how-to videos, to teach you guys how to work on your cars, save a little bit of money so you have more money to buy more car parts. That's what the hobby's all about. So that's going to be it for 2020. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and all of my previous videos. If you haven't seen them, I have playlists for all of my C5 content, all the C4 content, and all of my other vlogs and whatnot. So definitely go check them out. There's, I think, over 350 videos posted on this channel now. So a lot of content to catch up on if you're new here. So again, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please smash that thumbs up button. If you're not already subscribed, go ahead and hit that subscribe button below. We're getting close to 16,000, so help me get there. So let's welcome in 2021, and hopefully it is a much better year than 2020. So we'll see you guys next year. Take care.